What was he like in those days?
He was, well, you know what? He was always interested in every technical electronic gadget there was in the world. And, you know, but he didn't exactly have the focus to actually sit down and design and build them himself. But he did build projects. He built projects that, like, counted the number of cycles on a guitar string so you could tune it right.
But you were the genius, weren't you? You were the guy who knew the technical stuff.
What happened was, after Steve met me and we compared ourselves, what pranks we had pulled and what and what we'd done in electronics, and I had just somehow come up with this very strange genius at computer design, and I didn't even think I'd ever have a job doing it. So after Steve met me, never tried to be the designer of the pair. He went more globally. He always thought in terms of products. How are they going to affect people? It's not how do you connect a few chips together. It's what are they going to do that's useful. Like, that's sort of a selling point. It's sort of a marketing point. You have to think of the end user. And that really should always be number one. That should be
first.
Who
would have been more successful if you hadn't met each other, do you think?
Oh, Steve Jobs, definitely. I actually don't want any credit for, you know, starting the whole personal computer revolution. And he's really admired so much today for recent products that I've had absolutely no involvement with, iPods and iPads and iTunes stores and retail stores and all these other things. And everything was so incredible. And Pixar, who could have so many successes one after another, and really no failures? Nobody ever. So I think that echoes what Jack was saying about him being, you know, the most prominent business leader, you know, especially in technology of our time, probably, you know, the century type thinking. It's just too unbelievable.
You're still an Apple employee, aren't you?
I am still an Apple employee, and I receive a small paycheck, but it's because I want to
play. How much you get?
I think the check, I don't even see it, but I think it's a couple $100 every 2 weeks. I mean, it really truly is small. But
do you have any equity in the company?
It should be $1. I just want to be the person who can say he was on the payroll of the computer, of Apple's payroll computer, for every day since the very start. I've never been off of it.
Do you have a stake in the company at all these days?
My wife and I really aren't big, stock traders, but we keep two stocks, and it's Apple and Fusion.io, where I work.
What gadgets do you use?
Oh, my gosh.
An Apple consumer?
Number one, I use my computer with the full typing keyboard, because I usually, when I'm walking around during the day, I'm not one of those people that has to constantly be texting and constantly doing email and constantly in communication.
But it is an Apple computer, is it?
Apple, absolutely. Everything.
And do you have an iPod?
I have had non-Apple products. Many, many times I've had non-Apple computers, and I tended to hate them and not want to use them. And I found out ways that I could actually bring their screen up on my Macintosh, so at least I could do it where I felt comfortable. I have non-Apple phones, but, you know, it's largely I like to be familiar with the whole world of gadgetry and what are innovators thinking of, new ideas, and what are the best ones. You never find all the best ones in one product. And I try to be fair, and I don't always say I'm going to wind up saying Apple has the best product in a certain category.
But like many people, you've come back to Apple again and again because the design is brilliant, the technology is amazing, they work, they're functional, they're reliable. What is it about Steve Jobs that made him the genius he became?
His way of thinking, and I call it a higher level. You know, when I worked with him, he'd go into Apple, and he would not have thought out what kind of microprocessor you used and how many dollars it cost. He would think higher up. What does that mean to an end user? What can they buy for how much? And he was always a step above and ahead, like a more advanced level of thinking. And he was always very fast. He would thought things out that you would ask questions. Why don't you do it in red? You know, and he'd have five different good reasons why it should be blue. Always well thought out, either very brilliant or he walked around thinking about ahead of time. And a lot of ideas, you know, that I heard from him 10 years later, I'm finally coming around and they're coming.